my highly respected colleagues. My name is Honorable Muhammed Gudaji Kazaure, member representing Kazaure, Roni, Kwiwa, Engwashi. Mr. Speaker, I'm from the Gas State. Mr. Speaker, I just came in. I find that they are debating about women. So that is why I say I have to contribute, because in my whole life I love women. Because, Mr. Speaker, if I go back to my home, right now I'm in here in the chamber. I left my home and he's taking care of all my activities, my children, my everything at home by my wife. But what I observe is women, they need us, or they need the government or the people to give them opportunities. It's good to give a woman opportunity, but not too much. Because, Mr. Speaker, right now we give them some opportunities which is almost captured 70% of our opportunities. Now I spoke about my wife. Maybe you can call me now when I close, say you have to come back, or I will go to Kano this evening. So continuously, Mr. Speaker, it's good for us to give the woman chance in terms of politics, in terms of opportunities, entrepreneurs and others, because they play a good role in our life. They take care of our life, they take care of our children, they take care of everything. They cook for us, they need everything for us. But what I fear, Mr. Speaker, they control us at home. When we give them opportunity, when we give them opportunity, Mr. Speaker, outside, no? So when they control us outside and home, they will capture everything, Mr. Speaker. That is what I fear, because most of the women, they are very intelligent. Very, very intelligent, because you can see a chief, a big man, controlled by his wife. That is what I observe and I experience in this life. Because majority of the big people, if you need something, don't go direct to them. Go to the wife. You will easily get what you want. So if you give them more chance, they will, one day they will overthrow us. Because if you consider, Mr. Speaker, now I was voted, I came here with almost 60% to 70% of my vote is for women. So if women understand this thing well, they will put us out. I'm telling them the reality, Mr. Speaker, because if they will open the eyes of women, as I see, like this in this house, like Jinela and others, their eyes is open well. If they seriously, Mr. Speaker, if in my constituency I have somebody like Chinenda, he will get a woman and put me out. That is what you do. So we give them opportunity and we assist them in each and every way they need. We do good to them, we do justice, I'm fair to them, fairness to them. But we should not give them too much opportunity. Too much opportunity, because if you go to your constituency now, Mr. Speaker, majority of the voters, they are women. If one woman contest in your constituency, they will say, well, they go to support our sister. They will vote for her. And they will come here one day, you will find all these women in this chamber. And they will mess up. They will mess up. Seriously, if women become 70 to 80% in this chamber, they will mess up, Mr. Speaker. Because when we are the ones who when they go zigzag, we are the ones who threatening them. We are not controlling them. That is why God says they should come under us. They will marry them. They will serve under us. So God knows what is there with them. You know everything with them. That is why he said let them stay under our control. So Mr. Speaker, we do good to them. We do justice to them. Then at last, we should not give them too much opportunity. And Mr. Speaker, I am in support of the government to make sure in whatever, even the president, if the president can transfer to you, I am in support of it, to go and bring those girls, the girls and the remaining support girls, but I am not in support of the deputy minority leader for saying the president to resign. This issue, Mr. Speaker, you have to tell the leadership of this house, we are 100% loyal to the president. If somebody touch the president, it's like he touch our heart, and we will be out of control.
Okay, Gudaji's message is very simple. I think we've come to a climax. You have exhausted your time. Thank you very much for your contribution, Honorable Gudaji.